good dojo discipline, good manners, but I'm not that strict like the Japanese. I'm a lad from Wigan, you know, not Jap. So my instructor was a Liverpudlian, great street fighter. I've trained with Japanese, very strict, very particular. It's their way of doing things. In the West, we're a little bit more, you know, he's just a bloke, yeah? We are just blokes. All the difference is I've trained for 35 years nearly, yeah? So that's all the respect is about, and really that's all it should be about. If you train hard and you've done a bit of training, that's where the respect should come from, yeah? Just so you know my background, like I said, I've trained, I think, 34 years now, coming on for 35. I'll be 55 years old in December this year. I've been training since I was 21, after leaving college. My main job's a graphic designer, but I do some healing, alternative energy healing, chi healing, and martial arts, and that's what I've been doing all those years. It's the great love of my life. We've been training in our club in Hemel for 27 odd years now, non-stop. I've trained 4 or 5 times a week, pretty much non-stop, all that time. Our club's about the size of your club, you know, a dozen, 20 people, just depending on the night, yeah? My other instructor's Paul Perry, who's a 7th Dan. My first instructor was called Tony Christian, he's a 7th Dan as well. My main love was Dojo-ryū, but I also trained in Shotokan alongside one another. And I'm graded 4th Dan in Dojo-ryū at Wigan, 6th Dan in Jinsei Kai, which is a sort of Shotokan style, and 6th Dan in my own style, which is goju.co.uk. Got a website, have a look at it if you've not seen it, yeah? Your instructors, Steve and Mike, run a nice club here. You know, Karen's doing really well. It's nice to see good traditional karate. But like I was saying this morning, I don't often mention karate these days anymore. You know, if somebody rings me up and says, do you do kickboxing, is the usual thing. So I say, yeah. You know, if they do ring up and say, do you do wrestling? I say, yeah. Do you do cage raid? Yeah, we do the lot. Because we always have done, you know. And unfortunately, karate's got a bit of a bad name these days. I wish it didn't. So I often say we do goju, and they say, what's that? And I proceed to tell them, you know. But it's our job to really improve the image of karate as well, if we can, you know. Because when I talk to my young students, I'll say, what do your friends think? And they say, well, I don't mention karate. They all laugh, which is a great shame, great shame. I say, what do you say to them? They say, I tell them I do goju or kickboxing. And I say, all right, fair enough, which is what we do. Kickboxing is part of what we do. But it's a shame that's the situation, and maybe we should try a bit harder to change it, yeah? Because karate is a wonderful thing. The stuff we do, goju, came from China originally, so it's heavily Chinese influence, and the Chinese were the past masters of martial arts. The problem is, if you try to do any of the Chinese martial arts, there's so much of it, you can never really get it all in. So I think the Okinawans' idea was they're very practical people, like the British, and they had these Chinese emissaries, you know, military attaches and things that went to Okinawa, and that's where the Okinawans learned a lot of the stuff. And it was called tea in those days, you know. Tea just means, like a cup of tea, just means hand. So you were training in hand. And over the years, really quite late, the word karate came about. Kara meaning void, empty. Karate, empty hand, yeah. And obviously the Okinawans being practical people, sort of looking at all the Chinese blocks, or Bong Saos, or this Wing Chun, all this sort of thing, sort of thought, well, what about just do this, you know, just do this. And they simplified it all down and made it really practical and effective, you know, because they wanted a practical, effective fighting art. At the same time, Okinawans were great wrestlers, just like in Britain, we were great wrestlers. From earliest times, you know, going way, way back. So I'm sure when they developed the karate, they had a few wrestling moves in their mind as well. You look at goju, there's no high kicks. And people might say, well, how come you guys in goju are doing high kicking? There's no high kicking in the kata. Well, there isn't. So how do you explain that? And how do you explain that one of the leading guys of goju-ryu, Higona, was known as a legs Higona? Now, he didn't get a name like that because he couldn't kick, yeah? He was obviously a prolific kicker, and he must have done high kicks. But in the goju, there's no high kicks. And in a lot of styles, there's not many high kicks in the kata, because they didn't think in street fighting it was very practical. But, as we all know today, a high kick can be practical. If you've got the right trousers on, you're not going to rip the backside out of them. You can do some high kicks. Now, it's